Hello everybody, thank you for the introduction. Actually, I'm not a doctor. And today we'll speak about automatic quantification of enlarged perivascular spaces. So perivascular spaces is in the brain is the space between blood vessel and pia mater, and it is filled with interstitial or cerebrospinal fluid. And when it becomes enlarged, it is possible to see it on MRI, in particular in T2-weighted sequence. It is hyperintense and can have a tubular shape because it follows blood vessels. It's an emerging biomarker. So enlarged perivascular spaces are an emerging biomarker for cerebral small vessel disease such as dementia, stroke, or multiple sclerosis. And current research is done with visual scores. And our objective is to automate these scores for enlarged perivascular spaces. So we use a population-based data set, the Rotem scan study. So all scans were acquired with the same 1.5 Tesla scanner. The mean age of the participants in our sub-cohort was 74 years old and ranges between 60 and 90 years old. We used 2,000 T2-weighted scans. And for each of these scans, we have ratings of a single rater for the perivascular spaces in the four brain regions. This rating are the number of these perivascular spaces, and the regions are midbrain, hippocampi, basal ganglia, and centrum semioval. So our method is based on deep learning, so artificial intelligence algorithm. And it happens in two steps. Firstly, we segment region of interest. This is actually done with more standard methods based on ATLAS segmentation. And the second step, we use a regression neural network, which is trained with the visual scores. So the idea is that the artificial intelligence mimic the scorings of the rater. With this artificial intelligence technique, people have said, yes, it is a black box, you don't really know what's happening. But actually, although we don't give any information about the location when we optimize the algorithm, only the visual score, so it's just a number for a given region, it is still possible to compute heat maps which reveal the focus or the attention of the algorithm. For instance, on this image, you can see a centrum semioval. And in red are the areas which are discriminative for the predictions of the algorithm. Blue is non-discriminative, and orange is in between. And you can see it focuses on enlarged perivascular spaces, which is the desired behavior. You could argue that some smaller lesions are missed, so it's not perfect if you would like to really do a detection with this technique. So to evaluate quantitatively our method, we looked at correlation between the automated scores and the visual scores. We optimized our method on 1,600 scans, and we evaluated it on 400 interbedded scans. And we used the intra-class correlation coefficient in four brain regions, so like separately. And we compare this to the inter-rater and intra-rater agreement, which was previously reported for another subset of the same data set. And we noticed that the performance of the algorithm, the correlation between automated and visual scores, is always in between the inter-rater and intra-rater agreement, which is the desired behavior and which can be interpreted as the algorithm being as good as a human rater. We also checked the correlation with age, so between association between automated enlarged perivascular space score and age, and we looked whether it is similar than the correlation between visual scores and also age. And here's the forest plot of the odd ratio of confidence interval, and you see that the trend is similar. Notice maybe that, for instance, in midbrain, also some extent centrum semioval, the automated scores are more positively associated with age, which is not the case for the visual scores. So this interesting difference, maybe because they are more reproducible, because if you would look at the visual score but with a larger sample size, you would see a positive correlation for all the regions. Okay, in conclusion, so we automated the visual scores of expert human rater in 4 brain regions. It's possible to look at heat maps to check the structures that the artificial intelligence is focusing on. We show a similar association between automated score on edge and visual score on edge. And for future work, we'd like to evaluate our method on other data sets with other scanners, other centers. Thank you for your attention.